Good evening, everyone, and welcome to this year's James Rogers Concert. We are delighted to have this wonderful packed audience here tonight. My name is Kathy FitzGibbon, and I'm the chair of the music department at Lewis and Clark. Part of my responsibility tonight is to welcome you and give you some information. And to be totally frank, the other part of my responsibility is to keep you entertained while the world's most complex set change occurs behind me so that you don't feel too bored. That was our wonderful wind symphony performing, and then of course we're going to be clearing the stage and preparing for some additional performances. Before I tell you about those, however, I want to take a moment to just thank the Rogers family. They have been great friends to Lewis and Clark College, and they have helped us create this concert in memory of James Rogers, who was a music student here at Lewis and Clark. And it's been wonderful getting to know the Rogers family. And if we could just take a moment and acknowledge them, it's wonderful to have you all here. And James's brother John will be having a bit of a cameo later on in the concert, so you can look for that to happen then. So continuing on our performances tonight, we have a real treat next, and that is Bruce Neswick, who is our new organ professor here at Lewis and Clark, will be performing the famous Bach Toccata and Fugue, which is just probably my favorite, perhaps Halloween-esque organ performance that there is. Bruce is a very distinguished organist who's had a major international career. He's taught at Indiana University. He was at the Cathedral of St. John the Divine. Now he's here in Portland at Trinity Episcopal Cathedral as its music director. And we are so glad that you are now on our Lewis and Clark faculty as well, Bruce. So we're looking forward to hearing your performance in a moment. After Bruce has the opportunity to perform, we will hear from Nora Beck and Michael Severson. Nora is our James Rogers Professor of Music, and she has created a really special performance. This is a medieval piece that she is using as the basis of a sort of improvisation, so you'll get to hear a little bit more about that when Nora gets up in a moment. Then we're going to have Alex Addy, who is our Ghanaian drumming faculty member, will be performing with two of his colleagues, and both drumming and singing, so that'll be a special treat. We have several of our faculty classical musicians as well, Inez Fogler, Nancy Ives, and Susan Smith, doing a Paschalia by the Portland composer Thomas Svoboda, so that will be coming soon. One of our student jazz combos will also perform, and then you're going to hear some really wild music from the Voces Aureum Women's Chorus and our percussion ensemble. They're doing a piece called A Walk in the Garden of Earthly Delights that is inspired by the Bosch triptych, so you'll see that projected and get to hear a really rather wild and rather creepy performance from all of them. Finally, the combined choirs will come on and do a piece first by the sopranos and altos, then the basses and tenors, and then everybody in that very epic O Fortuna from Carmina Burana, which you all know from, I hate to say it, car commercials and other soundtracks, but also one of the great pieces of Western choral music. So we hope you will enjoy all of that. I'm feeling as if we're getting a pretty clean stage. This is exciting. You guys need maybe two more minutes or so for the choirizers. That is great. So you don't have to listen to me talk too much longer, just a little bit. So let me think what I'll tell you about next. I just want to say this is a really dynamic institution with some dedicated musicians. We figured out under Nora's leadership a couple of years ago that there are roughly 700 students who take music classes every year at Lewis and Clark. So it is a very creative, very musical school, and one where we all feel very fortunate to teach. So we're really excited to share the great students and great faculty of the Lewis and Clark Music Department, and of course, again, echo our appreciation connection to the Rogers family. So thank you all so much for being here tonight. We look forward to sharing this music with you.
Thank you very much. Any from between 1490 and 1510, when Bach was between about 40 or 60 years of age, the Garden of Earthly Delight, along with the Temptations of St. Anthony, are among his most notable works. The triptych is painted in oil on oak and is formed from a square middle panel flanked by two other oak rectangular wings that close over the center as shutters. The three scenes of the outer wing would fold and show a painting of the earth during the biblical narrative of the creation. The three scenes of the inner triptych are probably, but not necessarily, chronological from left to right. The far left panel depicts God presenting Eve to Adam. The central panel is a broad panorama of socially engaged nude figures, fantastical animals, oversized fruit, and hybrid stone formations. The right panel is a hellscape and portrays the torments of damnation. A special thank you to Nathan Ten, who put together our slideshow for this performance. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you.
my name is Adam Steele. I'm the director of Voces Aureum, the vocalist you just saw perform with the percussion ensemble. We've got the treble voices here at Lewis and Clark performing tonight. This twist, the poem is by E.E. Cummings and features such memorable lines.